by France. On the ground to the left, and it stays fair. Headed for the plate. The throw in. He's safe.
Ready to hit right there. There's something about pulling one down the line and shooting it through the infield that's just so satisfying as a hitter. It's just fun turning on a pitch like he did right there.
On the ground to first. There's one. Out. On to first. Out. Double play.
The 3-6-1 double play, in my opinion, is one of the toughest plays to make. You've got a pitcher covering first, and the middle infielder throwing to a moving target. Everything has to be perfect, and right there, they made it look pretty easy.
LeMahieu makes the grab, and that's the inning. A run on two hits, and they leave one. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Mariners 3, and the Yankees nothing. We go to the 8th, and stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe. Castillo back to work. In there at the knees. And it's a little off. The Yankees looking to rally. Swinging a foul straight back.
So what we're seeing is a lineup that's just out of sync with the pitcher. They're guessing wrong, and their timing's off.
Fights it off. You'll see another. Deal two.
One ball, two strikes.
Wouldn't chase that time. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
That's up night at the dish. Touching up for the third time right there. He just has it looked. Very comfortable at the plate. A little unsure of his timing right now, not picking up the spin and location of these pitches. We'll have some adjustments to make.
He's got it, and there's two away. Here's Gleyber Torres, 1-for-3. Swing and a miss.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
The Yanks trailing by 3 here in the late stages of game 3. Off the plate inside, and that's ball 1. Hits and misses, it's a strikeout. 8 innings. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the 8th, Tommy Canley.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
He's there, he's got it, and there's one down. They moved the fences in here at T-Mobile Park before the 2013 season, but it's still regarded as a pitcher's park. It can be pretty tough on hitters. Back to the top of the Seattle order, Josh Rojas up next for the Mariners. That's in for a strike.
Well, T-Mobile can be tough on hitters because there's less room in the outfield. So a liner that would be a hit in another park might just get caught. The most reliable way to score, hit dingers.
This one in the air. Wells makes the grab, and there's two gone. So digging in, J.P. Crawford.
Shortstop, J.P.
That's in there. That's strike 1. 2 down, nobody on. Here in game 3 of this American League Division Series. A dive, nice stop, and it beats him. What a play. And welcome back to the ballpark. Here's Alex Verdugo.
Alex.
And the pitch.
Verdugo.
Fouled off to the right. The pitch. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Popped up. Under it. Makes the grab. One down. Here comes Aaron Judge. 0 for 3 with two strikeouts and a ground out. Pitch misses there, and it's 1-0.
Definitely a frustrating day for the offense, but when they look at it, this guy's had his best stuff. Painting the corners, working on the edges, and changing speeds. Just a difficult one. You tip your cap.
2-0 to Cal. Here it comes. To the right side, Haggerty. On to first. And a couple of quick outs. So they're down to their final out. Here's Juan Soto. And first offering is fouled off. Left-hand hitter waits. Hit to right, and that should do it. He's got it. Ball game. And the Mariners take game 3 here at home and get themselves back in the series. So the Seattle Mariners live to play on. They are back in this series with a win in game 3.
And this totally changes the complexion of the series. If they can pull out game 4, everything will be in their favor in terms of momentum heading into a possible game 5.
On the other side, suddenly the job of moving on gets tougher, but they're still in a good position.
Yeah, they're not going to cruise into the LCS. They're going to have to work for it, and that's how it should be here in October.
Into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the New York Yankees taking on the Seattle Mariners. Joined by my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Schaumann. And Singy, there's been a lot to talk about already in this series as we head into game 4.
And I'll be interested to see if these teams approach it any differently, with one on the brink of elimination and the other just a win away from putting an end to this thing. You know, in the postseason, I think you have to treat every game the same, but there's something about an elimination game that can put a team just into a different mindset.
Yeah, and the strategy could certainly change in this type of game. It's hard to manage the same way when in any given at-bat, it can impact everything you've been working for throughout the season. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. And here's the first baseman, Ty France. Ground ball right side. Tosses to first. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. Two men left stranded, but they do push across one. Game 4 heads to the seventh inning now. We are tied 2-2. Back in Seattle, now it's the shortstop, Anthony Volpe. Kirby back to work. And a good eye there.
Down. You know, these Yankees, they're being honest with themselves, struggling to make contact in this one. The strikeout has been a big issue, but at least they're going down swinging. Got to get the ball in play, though. It's time to change up the approach to focus on making simple contact and just go from there.
On the ground to third. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield. Now he turns and heads for second. Check that. He'll stop at first with a single after putting on the brakes. Well, maybe that will end up getting him going.
Yeah, he really simplified there. Kept his shoulders square to the plate and wasn't trying to overswing. I think that's the key for him to have success through the rest of this series.
Austin Wells stepping in now for the Yankees. And takes low for ball one. Runner on the move. Pitch misses. Throw to second, and great jump. Now 3-0. Some activity in the Mariners' bullpen. Ryan Stanek up and loosening in the pen. Santos also throwing. And that's ball four.
definitely lost the handle during that sequence. Four pitches for the walk, and that last one didn't even threaten the zone. Catcher might want to go talk to him.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here is Gleyber Torres. 1-2.
Mechanics hits against the firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
And here comes Scott Servais as he's ready to make a change on the mound. George Kirby won't go any further tonight, and the line not closed on him yet as he's responsible for the runners on base. Back with a new pitcher after this. New pitcher on now, Taylor Saucedo.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep it within striking distance.
Here's Alex Verdugo. First pitch misses. And here it comes. Lifted in the air down the left side. He's under it. Makes the grab, one down.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces.
Aaron Judge.
Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Judge ball. In the box here, lets that one go for a ball.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Here's the swing and a miss.
At the dish, looking to look the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, boy.
Two on, one out. And a count 1-2.
He's dealing with a great two-strike hitter right here. The strikeout is not automatic.
And that one is lifted in the air. Two down.
Up next for the right fielder.
Juan Soto now. 1-3. That misses. Ball one.
1-0 count. Look for him to be aggressive here. He got some runners on base, an opportunity to catch a mistake and put some runs up on the board.
And now the lefty fouled off. He was late. Traffic on the bases with one already in late here in game four. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage.
Swinging. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand.
Sometimes he wears the...
We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh, Jonathan Loaisiga.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the third game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Hit on the ground to the right side. Takes it himself, and the leadoff hitter set down to open the seventh. And stepping in for the Mariners, Sam Haggerty. Bottom of the zone and a called strike. Bunted for a hit, and foul ball. Holding holding on to a one-run lead here in game four. That one down the line. Steps on first for the out.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Marlowe at the plate and takes high there. And it's even up.
One ball, one strike.
Ground ball left side. Oh, great stop. The throw, but he beats it. Nice try defensively. Great hustle. And the tying run is up.
Two outs. You just want to find a way to keep the line moving for the next guy. So an infield single right there does the job. Nicely done just putting it in play and getting down to first to keep this inning alive. You never know what might come next as a result.
Here's Josh Rojas.
Typically, the outfield defense will play a little bit deeper just to keep the ball in front, make sure that runner on first doesn't come all the way around to score and tie this ball game up.
Swung on, belted. That's back.
In this one, they've got the long ball working for them on autopilot. Took off a big part of the yard for that home run and just barely got it over the wall. I thought for a second he brought it back out there too. Gave it a great effort, but you know those plays are so tough to pull off, and I'm sure he'd love to have another shot at it.
Rizzo tosses to the pitcher covering the bag, and that is that. Two come in on this Seattle homer. It's now a 4-3 ball game. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth, Matt Brash.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Stanton, the leadoff batter, as he looks at ball one. Action in the pen down there. Andres Munoz appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Servais. One down. And here's a slow roller. And it's just foul. That was close. Misses. It's a strikeout.
Pretty big strikeout right there to start this eighth inning. Down one. Any leadoff base runner really makes this inning a bit more interesting. But now this offense has to switch from possibly trying to manufacture a run to needing to run into something or just try to string multiple hits together to get a run across the plate.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. Pitch misses, and the count even 1-1. And a big swing and a miss. Let's see that.
One ball, two strikes.
Stayed in the tunnel for a long time. No chance of even fouling it off.
And a pitch. That one not close. The count now 2-2. And there's a ball.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
DJ LeMahieu waits on deck. Swings and misses. Way out front of the slurve.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one. Getting him straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
Comes up empty. That's strike two.
No signs of wavering on the mound here in the eighth. He's looking rock solid so far.
And the next pitch is way outside. Swing and a miss. And that is that. Yanks. Back now to pitch pressure on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth. Ian Hamilton.
71.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Snags it on the run. And there's one away. Mitch Garver up to hit here.
Really nice job to get your first out of the ball game.
And a foul ball. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out. And now for Seattle. Ty France. Not even close there. Ball one. Runners at first and second with one gone here in game four of this ALDS. Soto makes the play, and there's two down. Here's Luis Urias. 0-for-3 with two strikeouts and a ground out. And ball one.
It's getting squeezed a little bit here late.
In there at the knees, and that strike one. On the ground at first. He handles it himself. That ends the inning as they squander a chance to pick up some insurance. Mariners leave a couple, and it remains a 4-3 game. Back at T-Mobile Park, new inning getting started. And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe. And a pitch. The shortstop takes a ball. Close, but called a ball. And that's ball two.
Plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt.
3-1.
The count 2-1. Swings and misses and one down below the zone.
A lot of times you'll see a pitcher maybe double up on a pitch. This guy will throw it three times, four times in a row because hitters just can't lay off of it.
And the righty deals. And a swing and miss. And a strikeout for the first out here in the ninth. He's two outs away. And next for New York, Austin Wells. Ground ball up the middle. Crawford on the run, sends it over to first. Not in time. He's safe.
Did a nice job getting there. Good throw, but very difficult to get anybody on that one as far as you had to go and throw. You know?
Yeah, no question. To the top of the Yankee order, and now Gleyber Torres. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Substitution now at first base. Pinch running here. Oswald Peraza. Munoz picks over Peraza back easily.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
The 1-0. And the slider catches the zone.
And this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
The kick and the pitch. Runner goes. Swing and a miss. One ball to second.
Well, I really didn't expect him to try to steal second base because he had a very standard lead at best. If you're going to try to get there safely, you've got to get more on that lead. You've got to get a better job.
And that's the ball game. So the Seattle Mariners stay alive with a clutch win here in game four.
They had one chance to save their season, Boog, and they made the most of it. These guys can handle the pressure of October. We've learned that much about them so far.
And it'll come down to a decisive Game 5. This postseason already providing plenty of memorable moments. Everybody, glad you're with us. MLB The Show brings you the American League Division Series. It's the Seattle Mariners going up against the New York Yankees. Alongside Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. And as we get set for Game 5, Chris, it seems like this series could still have a few twists and turns in it.
Yeah, Boo, the only negative here today is that the series is going to come to an end. As fun as it's been, I wish it could go on a few more games. And the way these teams have battled each other and with some of the amazing moments we've seen in getting to this point, I think we're in for a great one here in Game 5.
Hard to imagine it won't be a classic, Siggy. I'm ready to see what surprises are waiting for us. First pitch coming your way next. Here's Alex Verdugo.
No left field.
Siggy, Game 5 in elimination spot, and the spotlight is focused on this guy.
Everybody looks to the star players in big games like this, and this is what you get paid for. Time to come through.
And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Well, this is a tough situation with the bases loaded, but the healthiest mindset is just try to get outs one hitter at a time.
And a 1-0. Ripped, but it curls foul.
They need a strikeout. And you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play or get yourself a pop-up, something. But you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
The pitch. He's hit. One run is in. And they don't push it. Water holds a third. Base is loaded now with still nobody out.
Well, here we are, third time through the order. This is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
Swing and a ball popped up. And the infield fly is called.
Up next for the Yankees.
And now it's Juan Soto. Golden opportunity right here. And that one fouled off.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
That one missed.
There are all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning. Takes a little bit of time by the time that outfielder catches it, but a really good job of getting that run in from third.
Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. That one is absolutely belted. Rodriguez raging back towards the wall. He brought it back.
Center field area, and that's why he knows he's got a chance to run it down and make a great play. Leaps at the fence, excellent job, robs the home run to end the inning.
The pivotal Game 5 of the division series. And now the catcher comes up to him, Cal Raleigh. And that's in the dirt. And that's ball one. Legends really are cemented in the postseason. You think of David Ortiz heroics for the Red Sox, Derek Jeter as Mr. November, or Randy Johnson in the 2001 World Series, just to name a few. Next pitch in for a strike, and it's one and two.
Well, on that idea of postseason reputations, Boog, gotta mention players like Carlton Fisk, Reggie Jackson, and Madison Bumgarner. We were doing that game. Those guys really shine in the toughest moments.
Battling here as he fouls it away. The pitch.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count.
Well, you got to give him credit out there on the mound. This outing started off a little shaky, but he's found a way to settle in and turn this into a pretty good start. Kind of shows you a lot about his mental makeup as a pitcher.
Verdugo puts it away for the out. One away. The batter now, Jorge Polanco. He's already homered here in this one. That one finds the zone. Strike one. Swing and a miss as he was late that time. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. All tied up here in this decisive game five. Off the mark there. And the count one and two. Swings and misses. Had him out front for strike three. Chris, as we look back at the pitch sequence, he hadn't seen that curveball at all. How tough is it to adjust to something like that with a bunch of break when you haven't had a look at it yet?
Yeah, I mean, you're dialed up for something firm. You never want to take a called third strike as a fastball, so you're going to be a little anxious before you recognize the pitch. And right there, clearly didn't see what was coming.
And now it's going to be Luke Raley. The pitch. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. That's down and in.
Definitely a swing and miss slider down and in. He finished that really well. Just couldn't get him to offer at it.
And he hits a ground ball right side, and it goes just foul. Kicks and deals. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Offense held in check there. 6-7-8 due in the bottom of the sixth. All tied up at three apiece. Bottom of the sixth inning. Leading off, Anthony Rizzo. The wind of the pitch. Foul ball there.
You know, Boo, from time to time, players mix up their routine if things aren't going their way, and Rizzo is no exception. When he was in a slump in 2023, he changed his walk-up music to Taylor Swift. No bad blood there because it worked. He went 4-for-4 and hit his first home run in over a month. He even gave credit to Swift after the game.
LeMay stands in now and watches strike one. Action in the bullpen for Seattle. Gregory Santos getting ready to go. Saucedo, the lefty, warming up as well. Late on that fastball. This one in the air center field. Rodriguez settles under it, calls it in, and there's two away. Anthony Volpe stepping in now for the Yankees. Here's a swing and a drive left field, and he knew it. Gigantic blast. And just like that, they're out front. It's 4-3.
The one thing the pitcher didn't want to happen just happened. That's not an easy one to stomach. Love to see a hitter aggressive on the first pitch of an at-bat. You watch it from the on-deck circle, so when you step in the box, you're ready to pull the trigger wherever it's at. Really good job by the hitter. Total conviction on that swing.
So two away with nobody on. Austin Wells stepping in now for the Yankees. Line drive. And that's the inning. Another look at the long ball for the Yankees. 4-3 New York. You're watching the American League Division Series on the show. Back in the Bronx. Now it's going to be Ty France. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball.
On the mound, he had a little trouble back in the first, but it's been a different story the rest of the way. Oh. Really settled into this outing nicely.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Swings through that one for strike two.
One ball.
I'd say that stayed in the tunnel for a long time. No chance of even fouling it off.
Righty to the plate. On the ground. Down the line, and it's foul. Righty delivers. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Swings, throw it, and that's a strikeout. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. Mm-hmm. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you've got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
The line and the pitch. And that one fouled off. Trying to hold a one-run lead here in the late stages of game five.
One ball.
And it skips into there. And that's in the dirt. One down, base is empty. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. In time for the second out. Good job to clean it up after the drop third strike.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Swing and a foul straight back. Holding on to a one-run lead, we're here in game five of this American League Division Series. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Out towards left center, Judge really on his horse for this one. Makes the grab on the run, and that is that. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Gregory Santos.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Now he breaks his bat. And he takes it himself for the out.
Really nice job to get your first out of the ball game.
Now at the plate, Alex Verdugo. One for three. And there's a foul ball. Santos measures 6 feet 2 inches, 24 years old, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. Bounce to the right. Polanco whips it to first. Two up, two down. Here is Aaron Judge. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Here in game five. Here's the 0-2. That one the other way. Polanco gets it to first. Judge out on the play. And it's a 1-2-3 held in check. But they hold on to a 4-3 lead. Ready to begin the eighth. Here's Josh Rojas. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter.
Well, after watching the first inning of this one, you would not have expected that this pitcher would be in such a groove and still in the ballgame at this point.
And he chases a high fastball there.
Really going after it here. All fastballs to get ahead in the count.
Left-hand batter waits. And a foul ball. He stays alive. right-hander deals. And now one away.
Pretty good strikeout right there to start this eighth inning. Down one. Any leadoff base runner really makes this inning a bit more interesting. But now this offense has to switch from possibly trying to manufacture one.
On a line. Tattooed and gone. He'll take a jog around the bases. His second homer of this series, and we're starting over. It's 4-4. Chris, he's homered in back-to-back games now.
Yep, seeing the ball well, and he's got his timing locked in. He's looking pretty dangerous at the dish right now. With such an emphasis on launch angle, a low curveball plays right into the hands of those guys at the plate. Really good job of going down there and letting that swing work to get it back up into the air.
The pitch. This one smoked on its way out of here. A massive home run. And the Mariners have the lead. It's 5-4.
No pressure on the next guy, but that's back-to-back home runs. How many are they going to hit?
And first offering is fouled off. Base is empty, one away, and we're at the top of the eighth. Swing and a miss. No balls, two strikes.
He's just about to throw his 100th pitch. Man, he's got a chance to get through this eighth inning if he can get two more quick outs. Y'all, this is a good time to step out of the box, take a deep breath, reset. A couple of changeups. Probably won't see another one here.
Inside,
that pitch just misses the inside corner, and the count is 1-2. And another ball.
All right, so in this at bat, he's seeing a couple of off-speed pitches, now back-to-back fastballs. In this count, you definitely got to stay back. Make sure you don't get out in front and be prepared to shorten up and hit the ball the other way.
One down, base is empty. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Right-hander kicks, deals. And swing and a miss. Down on strikes. We didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Jorge Polanco. He's already homered in this game. There's the strike. Misses, and that is ball one. And a swing and a miss, and that's that. The two round trippers in this inning, the long ball was working, and the home back now. New pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Gabe Spire.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Soto, up to bat next, lays off for ball. Activity in the bullpen. Andres Munoz appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Servais. Stanek, a hard-throwing right hand. Oh, this one high and deep, way back there. And it's off the wall. And now the tying run is in the scoring position.
Well, that's how you respond. Leadoff man comes up, gets in the scoring position. Now there are several ways that they can get this run across.
Giancarlo Stanton to the plate now. And that's outside with a single base runner. Because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead. Fall off foul. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Stood absolutely no chance on that slider right there. And I don't mean to laugh, but that's a tough one. I mean, pretty much a perfect strikeout pitch. I mean, it looks like a fastball middle in. Kind of has cutter action, and it just bunches you up to where you can't get your hands through and the barrel to it. And not much you can do unless you recognize the spin early and you spit on it.
Swing and a ground ball to middle. That's a base hit. Coming home. Here comes the throw. He scores to tie it up. 5-5 now.
Such great concentration. Everybody on their feet, knowing that you can come through with a good swing. But there, he doesn't try to do too much.
One down. Here's the third baseman, DJ LeMahieu. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
1-1.
One away, tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. That's towards center. Rodriguez settles under it. He's got it. Two down.
The batter number 11, shortstop, Anthony.
Anthony Volpe will hit next. Slider misses outside. With the go-ahead run at first, near the bottom half of the eighth inning. That one hammered, but pulled foul. Here comes a pitch. And now 2-1.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far. He doesn't look anxious at all.
Two outs. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. And another ball.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
Austin Wells hitting on deck circle. Urias slings it across. In and over. But the RBI single pushes across a run. All even at five apiece. We're back. It's the top of the ninth. And there's a new pitcher on the mound. Ron Marinaccio. And here is Luke Raley. And the pitch. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. At the belt and fires. Slice the other way and foul. Hit. A leadoff single and the go-ahead run is aboard.
I'd say a mistake pitch in an 0-2 count. Too good of a pitch to hit right there. You have to expand the zone. Keep that leadoff man off first base.
Judge sizes this one up, brings it in. Here's Luis Urias. First pitch, and he just misses. One away. Tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. This to third. LeMahieu. One at second. Double play. And that sends us to the bottom of the ninth. We are tied.
Poetry in motion there as the second baseman turns the double play. Nice throw to first, and that's the way to end the inning.
So bottom of the ninth, and here's the catcher. Austin Wells. And he deals. High ground ball for baseball. Off to a good start with a leadoff down.
Everything came together for him. Smashed that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
So the batting order turns over. Gleyber Torres getting ready to hit. And fouled off. Winning run at first, nobody out. Here in the last half of inning number nine. Next offering misses, and it's 1-2. Just missed.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Kicks and fires. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building. Two, two down. Fouls it back with two strikes. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. Way inside, gets out of the way.
Well, on this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Boo.
And ball four to a board. It wasn't easy, but he earned that walk after a long at bat.
When you go that deep into an at bat, the hitter usually comes out on top.
So out of the bullpen for the Mariners, Taylor Saucedo. First and second, no outs. And up next for New York, Alex Verdugo. Breaking ball through there for a strike.
Really good job in this spot to get ahead in the count. He's going to have to continue, finish off this hitter.
Yeah. A swing and a miss as he chases way out of the zone. Close one, doesn't get the call. That one and two.
Well, if he's going to do something special right here, it's going to happen with two strikes.
And that one hit to first. Over to second for one. Back to first, double play. 3-6-3, nicely done.
Hey, they played the matchup right there. It worked out perfectly. Got the ground ball double play, and that changes the complexion of this inning entirely.
It's Aaron Judge now. Swing, and that ball smashed on the line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is the inning. So they can't push across the winning run. Back now, and we're in extras. A new arm on the mound here in the top half of the inning. Caleb Ferguson.
Bringing in the lefty with the left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here, so we'll see how it works out.
Squeezes it, and there's one down.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it. But in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
And there's a ball.
2-0.
There's a strike. And a count 2-1.
2-1.
One down, base is empty. Slam and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Man, there was no deviating from the fastball right there. He just kept coming after with it. Here it is. Hit it if you can. And he just couldn't find a way to put it in play.
So up next, J.P. Crawford. He's coming off a big swing of the bat in the eighth inning, Chris.
Yeah, he may still be riding a little high. And for him, hopefully the confidence is still there. It was a solo shot and a very important run in this game.
Slice the other way. That's a base hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going. And his hot hitting continues.
They kept him in the yard that time, but all he's doing now is passing the baton, and everything seems to get started around this guy.
And now it's Julio Rodriguez. Two outs. Runner takes off. That's it for a strike. Throw to second, and he's safe.
One ball.
In the dirt. No movement. Now a ball and two strikes. With the go-ahead run standing at second. And here in extra innings. That one to first. Rizzo. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Left for Seattle. Our score holds at 5 apiece. Now into the ball game on defense. Sam Hank.
For the Yankees. The right field.
He's in at shortstop. Saucedo back to work. Line drive. To the warning track, makes the catch.
Clearly ready to hit right there. First pitch of the inning, hits a bullet. It just is one of those bad luck ABs.
Giancarlo Stanton at the plate. And that one fouled off. Back to the mound, he's got it. In plenty of time to first and a couple of quick outs.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to run over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some runs while you're at it.
Rizzo now in the box, comes up empty with a swing there. Two down, nobody on. Pitch misses. Now one and two. Struck him out. Really fooled him with the breaking ball there. Back now and on the mound, the closer, Clay Holmes.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
The 0-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Jorge Polanco up next for the Mariners. Breaking ball inside. 1-0. Base is empty. One away. We are in the 11th. Deep drive down the line. Foul ball. The 1-1.
That's ball four.
That got him. And the potential winning run is aboard.
These types of mistakes usually turn out to be costly this late in the ball game. Things can really slip away in a hurry.
Popped up to the left, into foul ground. And there's two down.
Boy, that was a hanging breaking ball right there. I think he tried to do a little bit too much. Sometimes those eyes can get really big. I think his swing broke down as well, and that's what caused him to pop it up.
France in the box lays off for ball one. Swing and a miss. Chased it out of the zone.
That's that slope right there. He threw it extremely well. Just a little break. So tough to get that barrel to.
And a pitch. Good job to fight that one off. Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. On the ground to third. LeMahieu gets it to first. And that is that. Back here at extras, and a new pitcher on the mound in the bottom half of the inning, Ryan Stanek. And now it's DJ LeMahieu digging in. 0-for-3 with three flyouts. The pitch. That one misses, and that's ball one. And that's outside. Fouled off. He was late. And and just misses with that one.
Well, as a pitcher, when you make a big pitch down around the knees and don't get the call, it'll eat at you out there. So some handle it a little bit better than others. And right here, clearly letting the ump feel it a little bit.
Outside, and that is ball four.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, the game plan that he's sticking to.